Hi dear all, welcome to this session. So in this video we are going to talk about the concept of the regression, and thereafter the important thing related to least square estimation with some example. And then the most importantly, regression is a parametric learning, so parametric supervised learning. So there are certain assumptions in the regression. We are going to talk these particular things in the subsequent videos. And finally, the variable selection methods and handling of overfitting conditions and logistic regression. Okay. So these are all the important things. And finally, the analytics application to various business domains, right? So coming to the first part, let me introduce what exactly the regression is and how we are going to handle various concepts of the regression. So friends, regression is a supervised machine learning technique where the output variable is continuous. In the example of various data types in data science or machine learning, we have seen some different kinds of the data types, qualitative and as well as the quantitative. So if you are referencing the regression, which gives the measure, friends, measure means some value. So that is what we are saying, that as a continuous value. It's not a categorical thing, it's a continuous value. So prediction of the sales of a product, stock price, temperature, house price, all these things belongs to the implementation of the regressions. And many regression types we are having, friends, fundamentally. So there some of the regressions I am listing out. So simple linear regression, multiple linear regression, polynomial regression, stepwise, which is also known as dimensional regression, logistic regression, which is a classification technique, and then lasso regression, ridge regression, and finally the elastic net regression. Let us move to see one by one. And one more important thing is based on your kind of the variable, whether you are going to generate a single value or whether we are going to observe the difference between multiple values, we are having these regression models, friends. One is the univariate model and second is the multivariate. Okay, so again, in the univariate, so only one outcome, and if you are referencing that particular measure, the value, just by observing one dependent variable and one independent variable, then you can say that is a univariate. Only one variable is observed so as to compute the outcome. Multivariate means multiple variables. So based on the multiple inputs, if you could able to find out the, or if you could able to implement the regression, that belongs to the multivariate. Again, within the univariate, friends, we are having the linear and as well as the non-linear. We will see what exactly the linear, polynomial, non-linear kind of things in the subsequent videos. Okay. Again, with respect to the univariate, again, if we are talking about the linear, we are having the simple linear regression model and multiple regression model. We are going to see those particular things, how to handle this simple and multiple. And now, various conditions we need to observe, friends. What exactly in the previous slide we have seen. So let us have a look on the detailed narration. So the type of regression, which is the univariate, only one quantitative response variable, quantitative. Okay. So because always regression talks about the measures, we are having only one quantitative response variable, then you can say that as the univariate regression. Multivariate, two or more quantitative response variables. If you are getting multiple values, okay, two or more quantitative response variable, then you can say that is a multivariate. And simple regression, only one predictor, and in case of the multiple, two or more predictor value variables. Okay, so if you are working with multiple or multiple regression, then you can have the concept of two or more predictor variable. And now, actual important thing, linear. What exactly the linear model is? Linear specifies all parameter enter the equation linearly, possibly after transformation of the data. All the transformations are over, and we are just substituting without any complexity, then such kind of model belongs to the linear models. And coming to the non-linear, the relationship between the response and some of the predictors is non-linear, or some of the parameters appear non-linearly, but no transformation is possible to make the parameters appear linearly. So linear model generally gives the straight line kind of things, friends, and non-linear maybe curvic nature or something, some kind of the different graphs or different lines. If you see, then you can say that is a non-linear model. So the relationship between the response and some of the predictors is non-linear in nature. So such kind of the regression technique can be belongs to the category of the non-linear. But one of the important statistical measure is analysis of variance. All predictors are qualitative variables, ANOVA, and analysis of covariance. Some predictors are quantitative variables and others are qualitative. Suppose if all predictors are qualitative, then you can say that as they that you can implement with the type of analysis of variance. But whereas some variables are quantitative and some other are qualitative, which is mixed, then in that case, first you need to identify the covariance, which is the analysis of covariance. And logistic regression, which is altogether is a different story, friends. The response variable is qualitative. You might have seen here in the general regressions, we will be expecting the quantitative measures as per the definition. But in case of the logistic, the response variable is qualitative, that is categorical. So just we'll see this logistic in the classification kind of the model. And let me introduce what exactly the concept of the regression here. So what do you mean by linear regression is, it is a way of finding a relationship between a single continuous variable called dependent or target variable and one or more other variables, continuous or not, is called the independent variable. So in general, if you are referencing the linear regression, is a combination which observes the relationship between the continuous variable called the dependent or target variable and one or more variables which are independent variables. So in this equation, you can observe that in this diagram. So suppose I am making use of weeks, okay, time parameter, and as well as the accumulative savings. So based on the number of weeks, how a person is saving the money or investment or whatever it is. So just we are making use of the correlation of the coefficient. Just this particular line specifies, this is a regression line, friends, actually. So this line specifies that how a particular person, based on the weeks, the corresponding savings are listed in the y-axis, and here in the x-axis we are having all the number of weeks. And if you are referencing the correlation coefficient R, a measure of how closely observation points conform to the regression line. And one of the important aspect is, friends, just this particular model we have fitted. This line is generated by our algorithm, and these are all the actual points, assume that. Okay, so these are all the actual points, and definitely for our estimation and as well as the existing things, there is a difference, friends, actually. So there is a differentiation, and that particular differentiation is nothing but the error value. And if you are referencing the equation of these particular things, so in general y is equal to beta naught plus beta 1x. In this format you can observe the implementation of the regression, and here if you identify, so the beta naught starting value is 400, for example, so initial value, and beta 1, so which is the coefficient, and x related to the weeks, and this particular 307.50 specifies that the slope. So whenever it is increasing, automatically we are expecting the higher value for the y. So suppose the number of weeks are more, automatically the savings reflect in that particular number of weeks. If number of weeks are more, and automatically we are expecting the more savings. So this particular equation describing the relationship between savings and as well as the weeks. So similarly, in the generalization, this is y we need to compute, and x is the independent variable. So y is the dependent variable. So according to the definition of this regression, we need to establish a kind of the relationship between independent variable x and as well as the dependent variable y. Okay. And coming to the simple linear regression, when you have a single independent variable, then we can call that as a simple linear regression. Suppose if I am giving height of a person, I could able to find out the weight. Similarly, if I am giving experience as input, and I could able to generate the salary. And now coming to the specific equation of this simple linear regression, we are having yi equal to beta naught plus beta 1 xi plus epsilon I. So if you are referencing in the previous equation itself, we observed that this y is nothing but the dependent variable, and this is intercept beta naught, which is the initial value, and slope of this particular equation is beta 1, and xi is anyhow the independent variable. Okay, so this is what you call the linear component, and this is what you call the random error term or random error component. And after implementation of these particular lines, you can see in the first model, all the whatever the implementation you have done with the form of this particular straight line, so all points are very near to this. Okay, so if any implementation yields less error, then that is the best model. But whereas in the second example, so while estimating this particular equation, there are these particular actual points are a bit farther when compared with the implemented model. So this is again we have to revise, and we need to observe the erroneous situations, right? And coming to the multiple linear regression, when you have multiple independent variables, then we can call it as a multiple linear regression. So rather than taking one independent variable and establishing a relationship in the dependent variable, we are having a chance of dependent on various x values, x1, x2, x3 likewise. So if you observe this equation, so rather than taking y equal to beta naught plus beta 1 x1 plus epsilon, this time we are adding some other variables, like, you know, so yi equal to beta naught plus beta 1 x1, beta 2 x2, beta 3 x3 and beta n xn plus epsilon I. So here y is the dependent variable anyhow. Beta naught and beta n are the regression model coefficients. These are nothing but the beta coefficients, friends. In the implementation of this particular regression related to the beta coefficients is also most important. Okay, so because if beta coefficient is more, automatically we will be getting the higher value. And coming to the x1 to xn, all are the independent variables. Okay, and ei is a residual error. You can call that particular e as the residual error, or which is nothing but the difference between observed and as well as the estimated dependent variable for site I. So this particular error gives the difference between the actual values and as well as the predicted values. And coming to the best regression line, how to identify the line is a best regression line or the line of best fit. We discussed that the regression line establishes a relationship between the independent and as well as the dependent variable. That is the fundamental definition. And a line which explains the relationship better is said to be the best fit line. Suppose out of multiple lines, because as a concept of the regression, we use it to generate multiple regression lines in the algorithm. So suppose if any line is can be set as a best fit line, if it by observing that particular line, if you could able to explain the relationship in a better way, then you can say that as a best fit line. In other words, the best fit line tends to return the most accurate value of y based on x, that is cause a minimum difference between the actual and as well as the predicted values. So which is one simple equation, friends. Okay, so just we are implementing this particular model, almost all points are very near to this particular implemented model, that in a way I can say there is very less error compared with the existing values, that is the actual values and as well as the implemented values. So such kind of thing can be known as the best fit line. And here you can observe the differentiation between the predicted value, okay, and as well as the actual value. Okay, so if you are referencing, this is the actual value and this is the predicted value, and the error, if error is very less between actual value and predicted values, then you can say such kind of line as a best fit of line. Okay, and one of the important aspect while discussing this particular regression is the error implementation, because as we observed that regression altogether gives the notation of best fit line. So the best fit definition completely depends on the errors. There are certain various errors, friends. If you are referencing the regression, there are some errors existing in the literature of the regression. So sum of all errors. So sum of all errors means anyhow error means difference between the actual value and as well as the predicted value, and we are denoting that particular predictions as y hat, and we are making use of this y as actual value, and we are applying the summation after deducting the error values. Okay, just actual value minus predicted value, and we are summing up all these particular values, which is giving the sum of all errors. Sum of absolute value of errors, which gives the absolute values, modulus of So just if you are observing this particular actual value, so I mean just if you observe this particular modulus value, so this modulus will give the positive value, okay, so absolute value. Okay, even it is negative, then we are applying this particular mod function, automatically we will be getting the positive. And sum of square of all errors. So whatever the errors we are having, we are squaring the errors. Always we are trying to minimize the error, friend. Suppose if I am getting the error 0.0004, and if you are squaring that, even we will be getting the less error. So, and one more problem is also there with this sum of squares of errors. It is magnifying the positive value. Suppose if you are taking the 4, error becomes 16 because as you are squaring that. So automatically, if less error is there, you can make use of this sum of squares of all errors to minimize that. And if more errors are there, then magnification of errors is also there. And how to estimate the least squares, friends? Because the least square estimation is something like which is used to observe the difference between actual value and as well as the predicted value. Okay, but with the help of this y is equal to a plus bx. So where slope of trend line is calculated as we observed that the slope is maximum means you can get the higher value in y. So and automatically this particular b defines the erroneous things also. Reason is if more values are there and automatically there is a change in x and there is a change in y. So based on this particular convention, we need to compute some of the values like sigma x minus x bar. Here this is the mean value, friends, into y minus y bar, mean of this particular y, and summation of x minus x bar whole square. So assume that here, observe that x is nothing but the independent and y is the dependent value, that is normal. And the intercept is computed as beta naught equal to y minus beta 1 into x. This is a normal condition. Okay. And the intercept is a essay grade we expect to get when the time spent on essay is zero. So just there is a grade and as well as the essay writing. So based on your writing only, the grade will be decided. And the intercept initially put as zero. And every hour we spent on our essay leads to an increase of B in the grade the essay gets. Okay, we can work out B through the following, as mentioned earlier, x minus x bar summation into y minus y bar by summation of x minus x bar whole square. And this least square estimation, when calculating least square regression by hand, the first step is to find the means of the dependent and as well as the independent variable. That we did, friends. And we do this because of an interesting quirk within the linear regression lines. The line will always cross the point where the two means intersect. Okay, so because x is having one kind of the mean, y is having another mean, and the intersect point is almost a very important thing, because based on that particular intercept point only, we need to observe the error conditions. And we can think of this as an anchor point, as we know that the regression line in our test score data will always cross these points. So just you can observe the representation like this, friends. We are having some hours spent on essay and grade of the corresponding hour spent, and we need to calculate x minus x bar and as well as the y minus y bar, and thereafter multiplication of x minus x bar into y minus y bar, and finally we have to observe x minus x bar whole square. So in that regard, just we are having the denominator as 94.18 and numerator as 611.36. So just based on these particular points, you can substitute and we can finally get the a value and as well as the y value with respect to the hour spent on essay and as well as the grade values. So the main point in this particular least square estimation is, friends, how to observe the equation and how to differentiate between actual value and as well as the predicted value. And the least means here we are trying to minimize the values. So whatever the value I'm getting and I'm squaring these particular things, then automatically the error will be less. Okay, so this is what how you can refer the fundamentals of the regression, and we have seen how we are going to make use of the least square errors. Okay, thank you.